the stretch.
I like sugar. I'm like addicted to crack.
But nutrition is a big part of it. And then when you exercise, like what we're doing right now, more like a circuit type training, that helps you too. Like you just don't take like really long breaks and stop. Yeah, like rather than just sitting there, you just do like sit-ups or something, or just keep it moving more. Because if you do like really low rep, high rest in between, like say you do like heavy weights, and then you rest like 3 minutes in between, you're not like turning into a cardio session. So when you constantly move and constantly do something, that's you're kind of working that cardio and the strength at the same time. But there's also like a lot of artificial ways that people do it, like they dehydrate themselves and stuff.
It's not good, right?
Yeah, it's not.
I need water.
Like most of the stuff you see in the magazines and even on video, it's not even really that real. Like, brush and stuff like that. So it's best to like look at a real person and seeing like where they're able to get their abs. That's a little bit more realistic. As long as they're not like taking like some crazy supplements or something. But you don't really see that many people with abs that are like super cut, you know, in real life, you know.
I figure if I'm going through all this pain, I might as well get it.
Some of it, part of it is genetics too. Some people just have it, like just more naturally more cut on that area. Like my father, for example, does a bunch of cardio. His abs are cut, but they're not like what you see in the magazines, you know what I'm saying? Like a lot of that stuff is like, it's artificial, right? Like if you dehydrate yourself like 3 days, it'll be really cut, you know?
Well, I did a bodybuilder, and that's what you said, like, for a competition, they dehydrate themselves, so the skin's tight.
Yeah.
And that's where you see it.
Yeah. Yeah, because normally when you're naturally, like, hydrated, your abs are not that defined.
Well, Freddie, I have a four-pack on top. I think it was girls that can be.
Say what?
Girls, they're bottom parts, but I've always had abs. Whereas my sister, they always had that little pouch.
Yeah. And that's probably for the babies. I mean, it's just what their bodies are for, you know? To have more, like, storing more fat, you know?
Because you were in gymnastics. Were your sisters in gymnastics? Yeah, I mean, you probably conditioned your body.
Because I was in this bodybuilding phase back in college, and I ran like 4 hours a day, and I cut out like all the carbs or something like that, or I stopped eating all meat and stuff, and I did all that, and I even tried to dehydrate myself, and it got really cut.
Well,
but it's not good for you.
What'd you need for protein? Because that's like the one thing your muscle needs.
Well, I was just working out a lot, and I cut out something, it was the Atkins diet or something like that. I did that, and it was really cut, but I lost like 15 pounds. I was really light.
Did you feel good?
No, it wasn't healthy. I wasn't that strong either. But it was just really defined. It's just like I said, it's a give and take. Like you get really cut, you can get weaker. Or you get really strong and then you're not as cut. It's a give and take. It's, you know. But like I said, like the bodybuilders and what they do, it's not realistic. It's just artificial. Like if you meet somebody, like, you see how hard she works out, you see how hard David works out, you see how I work out, you see how hard Derek works out. Look at their abs and that's more realistic opposed to like you just seen a magazine. It's like they might airbrush it, they'll do dehydration, they'll take a bunch of supplements. That's not realistic development, you know. Even my father, you know, he has really low body fat percentage, like under 5%. But his abs are not like super cut. like I said, some of it's genetics too. It's like saying like you're born with black hair and you wish you had blonde hair. It's like you could dye your hair, but then it's not, you're gonna keep having to do it, it's not natural.
So
some people they might just have naturally cut abs and it's not even, it's just that. Like somebody just born taller, you wish you were taller, you're not gonna get that because you weren't born that way.
That makes sense.
So some people work out as much as they want, their abs are not gonna be like super defined. But for sure, if you know what you're eating, you know that you're not eating that healthy, you know what I'm saying? And you know that you can work out more, then you can fix those, and then you'll definitely get more defined. Like, in a natural, healthy way, you know? But if you're running like 2 hours a day and working out like crazy and eating like really healthy, you know, it's probably gonna be where it's gonna be, you know?
I think we need just, I don't, cardio. More than what we do here.
Yeah.
Like running.
Yeah.
Most unnatural thing in the world.
See, like a lot of bodybuilders, because I've read, you know, books on it, they don't like to run because it kind of ends up like burning their muscles. You know, because like if you start burning out all the fat and you've got no more fat left, it starts burning the muscles away. So then they don't like to do a lot of cardio. Because they're trying to get like size, you know?
I don't think I'm trying to get it. I want to be the best I can be. I think I'm realizing that's a mixture of stamina and strength. So I just think that I was hoping I could get rid of this little option up there. But it was gone when I first came here, but I wasn't really eating. When I first came here, I was real big. That's why I think I'm so skinny.
That's what I'm saying. Like if you don't eat and you're malnourished, like people in the third world countries, like Ethiopia or whatever, they're like super cut, but then they don't got any muscles, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like they might be able to win they're gonna win the marathon, but they're not gonna be able to win like a strength.
Yeah.
So it's a give and take. Like, so for example, you decide to be a marathon runner or you decide to be like a sprinter, you can't be like the best at both. Because as soon as you choose the marathon, you're gonna lack the sprinting. If you choose the sprinting, you're not gonna be as good as a marathon. So, like the balance is kind of like, you know, trying to get good at everything, but like I said, you know, from my experiences, super defined abs are not healthy, and it's not efficient for like athletes either. You know, like if you want to get good at a certain sport.
Yeah, I guess that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, like people, like they look at people's abs, and they usually that's their focal point. They usually look at a person's abs and be like, oh, you know, he's fit, he's not, or he's in better shape than this person. But I think that's wrong because if you look at like most of any other sports, like something like basketball, it's not about how defined their abs are. They got jerseys on. It's not like, oh, he has more defined abs than him, so he's better than him. No, it's their performance on the court, you know, and. People like put like an over. It's kind of like they're trained to habitually put an overemphasis on the abs over everything else. It's like somebody can have like really ripped abs and then they have a like really weak back or like a really weak chest, but people still look at the abs and be like, oh, you know, he's really fit because he has cut abs, you know. But really, it's like every muscle group in the body is important. It's not just that area. But I think when you get older, it's just harder, you know. But if you like go the skinny route, where you say you come in here and instead of doing like you just do like really high reps, like 30 reps for everything, and you just keep it moving constantly, and you're constantly sweating, you're probably gonna lose 10 pounds, and then your everything's gonna shrink, but then your abs are gonna be more cut. So you either decide to be like thinner or a little bit more weight on you, but then not as defined in the abs, you know? That's like a personal decision, you know?
Right now I'm working on stamina, so wherever that takes me. Is Dave coming Saturday?
We'll be in Wisconsin.
Oh, okay, that's what she said. So.
We're going to a dinner theater. So we'll be here probably tonight and Thursday.
Thursday night?
Yeah.
And then you guys be back when?
You won't see me probably till January 8th, 9th, or 10th. Because I got drill January 4th, or 3rd, 4th, and 5th. So I'll be in the Peoria. Alright, gentlemen.
Alright.
So when you come back?
Tonight.
Tonight?
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll call you if something happens. Because I got counseling at 3, and I think we want to try to eat in town, or like, see the lights.
Yes.
But if we don't, then yeah, we'll call you.
Okay.
We're gonna try.
So for example, like, say you're a bodybuilder and your whole goal is to get more defined and sit, like just the abs. Like what they would do, for example, instead of stretching like this, just all cardio. Just basically skip the stretching. Because it's not important to them. They don't care if they're wrestling. They just want to look and get nice abs. So then rather than stretching for 30 minutes, you can be doing a jump rope or a jumping jacks for 30 minutes straight. You know? Like, that's the mentality of bodybuilders. It's all about like how they look. So then the whole training is just focused around that, you know? It's a different type of training than how would a martial artist would train.
All I can say is I'm trying to keep up. I'm getting discouraged. I'm trying. Everything you ask me to do,
today,
sometimes I just tap on.
Today you kept up pretty good.
Yes,
yeah.
I think about this stuff when I go home a lot.
Yeah.
And I said, you know what? I went to the store, got a protein bar, got Powerade instead of water. I said, just shut up and do what he says. The only thing I'm seeing is improvements.
Yeah.
Even though they're small. And I think you said you've been doing this 20 years.
Yeah.
So you've shown me that you know what you're talking about. And then when we train, I see just like yesterday, the little details, like, you know, don't hold your hand like this. I mean, just I appreciate the time you put into the little details. I don't want to discourage you, you know what I mean, from training. Because I can imagine if certain people come in here, it's like, this is not really what I envisioned when I opened my school, you know, like, because I figure if you're encouraged, it's just going to give a better product for me anyway. So, I'm trying to bear up to my limitations. I did not realize I was this out of shape. But I've never come across this type of intensity.
I mean, you have it's almost like Bruce Lee's the same way, and most people that want to be good, they like this is like their perfection. Like you're actually just. You to the average person, you're actually in really good shape. But then you still, it's almost like humbleness. But you still feel that you're not, and that's what drives you to get better. That's good, you know, like that humbleness where you feel like, rather than getting arrogant, being like, oh, I'm already in the best shape and I don't gotta do nothing. Like that's what I want. It's hard to find that, but I want that intensity here. It's not easy to find, and I've dealt with it a lot where you train people for like, months or even years, and then they just give up. And then it's like all those little details that we're talking about, it didn't do any good. It's wasting my time. And I've learned through time that, you know what, the people that I don't feel are that serious, I'm not going to go through details for what? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's like they're not even like putting the effort in to like come in time or train consistently or to even get themselves in decent shape. Then why do you even need to know the details?
Right.
You know, like little minor details are not important right now. Do your jumping jacks. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like that's what I learned through time, because it's like it's disappointing, but imagine that you had a kid and then he dies in 2 years.
Right.
You know, it's like
right.
You know, you want to see him grow, mature. But that's kind of how I feel when people come here after a few months or a year, they end up leaving.
Well, why lay a foundation if there's no future?
Yeah. Yeah. And that's why I like to separate between like fitness. And that's what we're talking about in the beginning, fitness, self-defense, and martial arts. Because some people, they don't really have that much interest for the martial arts, and they just want to get fit. So those people, like I know, okay, I don't need to commit too much. Like I don't need to explain too much to these people because they're not here for that, you know?
Right.
So it's just kind of like what we talked about before, like, you know, where you're like, you know, it'd be nice if we all got together and just like, get to know each other, which that's what I was mainly promoting in the beginning. But another thing is, if you know somebody's not going to be there for long, why spend all the time in it? It's like a relationship, like a one-night stand or something. Or like,
yeah.
Or like you get in a relationship for a year, you give your heart out to the person, and then they bash your heart to pieces, and then you got to move on to the next person.
Yeah.
That's kind of how I feel with my training. Is like, I don't want to like, I have to be careful, like, you know what I'm saying? Because you're dealing with so many people, and you don't want to like basically put too much time with certain people that are just going to be gone anyway, you know? And then you don't want to like get people close that are going to end up leaving. Like say for example, like you and Derek become like best friends and you just quit, or he just quits. It's just like, you know, you're just going to leave like that, you know? So it's kind of like there's like a bond that's developed and you want to keep it strong. So like Derek brought in Annette and they have a really close bond. And then that their bond gets stronger here, and then it gets stronger between me and Jenny, and the kids and everybody, you know. So that's the difference of what I try to do here, opposed to just like the average like commercialized business where you don't have none of that. It's like McDonald's, you're just serving people. You don't care who it is, you know.
I was thinking yesterday, because I was thinking about the things you were saying about the competitions and stuff like that. I really like the spirit that you displayed, you know, as a seafood, you know, because you're all about, like when we train, I've been able to help Angel, Angel's been able to help me, I've been able to help Jewel, Derek's been able to help me, you know, it's not a competitive, it is competitive, but it's not a selfish competition. You know, it's more of a, you know, let me better myself, or let me, you know, like I'm trying to compete against myself almost.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what like ultimately the highest way is like no competition, but below that is like kind of like a healthy competition, you know? And most people, they can't let go of the competition altogether, so what I try to promote is like a healthy competition. And when it comes to like fighting or sparring or combat, you gotta be very careful with it because it gets very unhealthy very quickly. You know, even we weren't even making contact and Angel gets hurt. You know what I'm saying?
We all got hurt.
Yeah, Angel gets hurt. Derek got a little bit hurt. You know, he hurt his foot. And then Tim got a little hurt. And that's not even any contact. Imagine if there's like contact and you're trying to prove like, hey, I'm better than you. I mean, it's just like, it gets very unhealthy very quickly. You know, and like when I'm trying to promote something like healthy but playful. Like Corey comes to me last night. He's like, I wanna be on that board. He's like, what can I beat you with? Like what can I beat you? I'm like, maybe you can beat me with a leg raise. And now she's trying to beat me on that. Like the leg raise is over there. She's like, I'm gonna get 50, I'm gonna beat you. I'm like, alright.
That's
yeah. Yeah, so then she's trying to do 50. And right now she's at 25, you know, and I'm like, all right. Then it made me like, all right, I gotta make it harder for her.
Yeah,
so I'm trying to do
yeah.
more. So then the record was 36, And then last night I did 37, just one more, you know? And then David, he beat me in the vertical jump. He got 29 inches. And I was trying, like one night I tried like, I swear like 30 times to try to beat, I couldn't beat it. Like, he just, I'm like, you got that right here. This other guy, he just owns the bench press, because he's the biggest guy here. Dude. He bench pressed 205 pounds. I'm not gonna beat that.
I can catch up to that.
And then there's another, but there's the other record for like people with body weight. So then if you bench press your body weight as many times as you can,
yeah.
Right now the record is 33. So that's another record thing. So it's just like fun things like that, you know.
I mean, like when I was lifting weights, it was me and my cousin.
Yeah.
My cousin. And we all lifted different weights, like different, you know, like I might be 285, he might be 225, the other one might be 250, but it wasn't the amount of weight, it was, you know, whatever you put on the plate, you finish.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, so it's like, come on, you got it, you know, we didn't, and it was easier too, we were like, I mean, this class is unique. In that every sport that I've been at or played in, just, you know, not like in school or anything, just regular. If there's a woman around, you get hurt. Could be your girlfriend, could be your mom, could be your daughter. You know what I mean? But somebody is gonna get, I think it's just the nature of men. But this in this class, it's not like that. I've noticed that. Because we used to go to every Sunday play basketball. No girls, no problem. You brought your daughter, somebody's glasses got popped in their eye. Or, you know, you bring your girlfriend, somebody broke their ankle or something. I mean, it's just, it's crazy. But yeah, I really, really enjoy this. My competition is like myself and trying to... Like the other thing I was telling C and Josh is, if it was just me and you in this class, no way would I be doing this. I'd be like, I can't do this. Who can do this? You know what I mean? But then it's like, I'm looking around and everybody in the class is doing it. So I'm like, I'm the problem. You know what I mean? So I have to do this. It's like, so I'm doing it the best I can, and I'm seeing the benefits slowly. I'm thinking like, I'm not in this for a month or a year. You know, this is what I'm going to do. So eventually, one day, it's going to all click.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's probably gonna like be a bunch of things at once. It's just gonna be natural, it's second nature, but it's just gonna take time, especially for me, because I like rhythm. I have to go through drills a lot of times in order for certain things to be second nature.
Yeah, I've met people where they're like really fit, but just very uncoordinated.
Yeah.
Like just like they can't dance or anything.
Yeah.
And a lot of it. The martial art aspect is like combine the fitness with that dance. Like say Michael Jackson was like super fit, he'd be a great martial artist.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because he could dance.
He was a dancer.
Yeah, he was a dancer.
Yeah.
And you know, the people that can dance and move, they're great martial artists.
That's why I want Josh in this class.
Yeah.
I really want him in this class. He is a great dancer.
Oh yeah?
Great dancer.
Just hip hop type dancing? What kind of
hip hop, step, and you know, crump. He can do a lot of things. I have a little sister, so I need to get her in here. She's a dancer too.
Yeah, dancing, and that's something that's a different type of learning. Like it's not just about just jacking out a bunch of jumping jacks.
Yeah.
Like dancing is like it's like something that takes more like time and coordination development.
I was really glad to hear C say she was gonna come back though.
That's great.
She was like, she was looking in the mirror. I'm like, oh, I think the mirrors just make you look slightly bigger than you are, and I hype you up, you know? It's like, I'm not taking my fat ass back in that class. So I was looking in the mirror, I was disgusted with myself. Why? She likes you too. She really likes you. She has
some reason she likes to see me and Dave go at it. But she likes this, she likes your dad. Because she talks, I mean, she can ask me, like, how, like, when I go home, she's like, how's his grandmother doing? I'm like, I don't know. She's like, you didn't ask? I'm like, no, I asked what we talked about, but she asks, like, I guess because I come here so often, she asks, like, she talks about you guys, you know?
That's crazy.
So I'm glad I talked to my, you know, I want serious people in here, though. I don't want, like, because sometimes I think about, like, if people just come that aren't gonna eventually stay, it kind of messes up our session, doesn't it? Because then we can't do more serious things.
Exactly.
Like, if there were a bunch of new people, we wouldn't have been able to do what we did Saturday.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that was fun. It's just that there's just the injury risk. I'm like, man, the people already called me. There's two people that's trained the next day. They both called me. Canceled. Oh, I'm hurt. I'm like, oh my god. And then Jenny's like, oh my god. She's like, let have him go through labor. It's like, I can complain about a finger.
I can't see you guys.
Okay, let me get you up there. Alright, once you guys work on that form, Richie, why don't you help him out with that? Lead it face this way.
The form?
Yeah. Actually, we'll have you face this mirror here. Richie's been working on it for a while, so he's gotten pretty good at it.
Alright.
So we'll have you.